Very good morning to all of you, my dear friends. How are you all? Good. So, dear friends, till now we have completed the concept of a capacitor and the parallel plate capacitor. To find the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor when the capacitor plates are separated either by vacuum or they are filled by the dielectric, whether partially or whether wholly. And after that, my dear friends, we have completed the concept of the combination of the capacitors in series as well as in parallel and also in various combinations. Now today, my dear friends, we are going to start with the concept of what we call as a spherical capacitor. So today our topic will be, first it will be spherical capacitor. Now, as the name itself suggests, that it is a capacitor which is in the form of a sphere. That means, again, there will be two plates, and these plates will be in the form of spheres. So there will be one plate, which is, let us say, plate number A, and there will be another plate, which is again a spherical plate, which is surrounded by plate B. So this combination is called a spherical capacitor. Now, it will also be used to store the charge in the same format it was used in the parallel plate capacitor also, my dear friends. Now, when we charge a capacitor, you know, it can be charged to, let us say, a limit V. Now, if we want to put more charge on this parallel plate capacitor or this a spherical capacitor, in order to add more and more charge, what we have to do? Because there will be a force of repulsion between the two charges, one which is already here and the one which we are trying to put more. So we have to do some work in order to put this charge in the capacitor. And this work done will be stored in the form of energy in a capacitor, and regarding this we will talk about later on. So first of all, a spherical capacitor is a capacitor which is formed out of the two spheres A and B, let us say, having the radius A and the radius B. Now, you know, if suppose I charge the capacitor, the spherical plate A with a positive charge Q, then due to induction, you all know that on the inner surface of the charge, or you can say of the plate B, there will be a development of minus Q charge, and on the outer surface of B, there will be a plus Q charge on the spherical plate B. Now, if we earth this outer face of plate B, then you know the entire positive charge will go down into the earth, and you will be left with only these two charges, the plus Q charge on the plate A and the minus Q charge on the plate B. And due to this, what will happen? There will be a formation of an electric field, or you can say there will be a development of a potential difference. There will be a potential difference. And you know that the capacitance of a capacitor is given by Q upon V. This formula we already know, that the capacitance of a capacitor is given by the formula, which is Q over V. It means if we are able to find this value of the potential between these two plates, then we can find the capacitance of this spherical capacitor also. It means my first duty will be to find the value of the potential between these two plates. And my dear friends, this we have already done when we were talking about the Gauss theorem. We all know that the electric field, what is electric field? You know, it is dV by dr. Electric field is given by dV by dr. So what will be dV? What will be dV? dV will be equal to E dr. This is the concept from the Gauss theorem we have studied. In order to find the electric field at a point, we have to consider a Gaussian surface. Let us say that Gaussian surface be at P, and obviously it will be also in the form of a sphere. And with the help of this, you can easily find the value which you have calculated during that time. If you want me to solve it, you can solve it. Otherwise, you know the value of this electric field which we have calculated in that format was equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square, where R is the distance of the Gaussian surface from the center of the sphere. Is it clear, my dear friends? Now, in order to find this value of entire system, what we will do? We will put this value of E here, and then we will integrate it within the limits from A to B. Within the limits from A to D. So what I will be getting? dV is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R square dr. This is the value of dV. I have simply substituted the value of what we call E. Now, in order to find the total potential, what we will do? We will integrate. So, integration of dV will be the integration of this value, and within the limits of A to B. Now, you all know that when we solve this value, what I will be getting? V is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught into Q. This will come as common, and inside we will be left with शाबाश, 1 ओवर r स्क्वायर एंड dr, एंड व्हेन वी टेक दिस अप व्हाट यू विल गेट, v इज इक्वल टू 1 ओवर 4 पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट q इनटू r रेज टू द पावर माइनस 2 dr. And you all know that what is the integration of x raised to the power n? Very good. X raised to the power n plus 1 over n plus 1. And when we add plus 1 here, I will be getting minus. So what I will be getting on solving? I will get minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q into 1 over r and limits from a to b. And when you apply the limits, what do you get? V is equal to minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q into 1 over b minus 1 over a. That means upper limit minus lower limit. This is what we are able to get. Now, when we solve it further by taking LCM, what you will be getting is v is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q into ab, this will be 1 over a minus 1 over b. We have taken minus common from here, and this minus will become plus. So interchange. Now when I solve this, v is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught into qab over qab over b minus a. No. It will be q into b minus a and over AB. Is it clear, my dear friends? Chalo, shabash. Now, this is the value of the potential. And we are supposed to find the capacitance. So, I will put this value of V here. So, when I put the value of V over there, what I get? C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught, because see, it is q by v. So q and q will cancel. This denominator will go up. And this numerator will come down. So it will be coming something like this. So this is the capacitance of a spherical capacitor, which is presumed to be filled with air. That means we are talking about a spherical air capacitor. In case there is the presence of dielectric, then my dear friends, your dielectric constant K will also be introduced in that. And accordingly, you can get the value for that to multiply by k also. Is it clear? So, once again, you can just go through this article, get the confidence, and proceed further. And after 2 minutes, we will continue with another type of a capacitor, which is called cylindrical capacitor. Okay? Good. Friends, after completing our what is called as a spherical capacitor. Now we will continue with another type of a capacitor, which is called a cylindrical capacitor, which is called cylindrical capacitor. Now, as the name itself is suggesting, that again it will be a capacitor in the form of a cylinder, and in the same procedure we have to proceed, as we have done in the parallel plate, as we have done in the spherical, the same we will follow in our cylindrical capacitor. Suppose you have a cylinder which is let us say having a radius A, and it is charged by let us say plus Q. There is another cylindrical body which is covering this entire cylinder like this, in the form of a cylinder only, and let us say its radius B equal to B. Same thing, it is used to store the charge, format will be same. Now when the inner cylinder of radius A is charged to a charge, or it is given a charge plus Q, then due to induction, same thing, the charge of minus Q will be developed on the inner face of the outer plate, whereas the charge of plus Q will be developed on the outer face of the outer plate, or you can say outer cylinder. Now, the outer face of the outer cylinder, if we earth it, then this entire positive charge will go down into the earth, and again we will be left with these two charges, which is plus Q on the inner cylinder and minus Q on the outer cylinder. And again, due to this, there will be a development of a potential or the electric field. Again, you all know that the capacitance will be given by Q over V. Again, in the same format, because we want to find what is the small potential on the Gaussian surface, we know it will be equal to E into dr. To find E, what do? Same format. We will consider a Gaussian surface, again which will be in the form of a cylinder, and try to find the electric field at that point, and then we will integrate it within the limits from A to B. Is it clear? Okay. You know that for a cylindrical capacitor, we know that for a cylindrical surface, the electric field, what we have calculated during the Gauss theorem, is given by Q over 2 pi epsilon naught R into L. Q over 2 pi epsilon naught R into L, where the L is the height of and R is the radius of the Gaussian surface. Is it clear, my dear friends? So once we proceed like this, we will put this value of E over here. Now, this is the value. Now see, try to understand. If this article come in your examination, then you have to find the value of E using the same method as we have done in the Gauss theorem. Here I am, for your simplicity, I am applying it directly. So what I get? I get dV is equal to Q over 2 pi epsilon naught R into L into dr. And in order to find the potential for the total system, what we will do, we will integrate dV, and that also within the limits from A to B, Q over 2 pi epsilon naught R into L dr. So whatever is common that we can take, so I get V is equal to Q over 2 pi epsilon naught L into 1 over R dr from A to B. Now, my dear students, my dear friends, the friends, those who are having mathematics, they know it, okay, the integration of 1 by R cannot be obtained by the same method. We cannot make it R raised to the power minus 1 dr. Because when we do this, minus 1 plus 1 will become 0 and that will go something else. So just remember that integration of 1 by R dr is log of R. That is called log of R. That means logarithm. So I will put it dV is equal to Q over 2 pi epsilon naught L into log of R to the base E from A to B. This is read log of R to the base E. Now you have to apply the limit. Now when we apply the limits, what do we get? V is equal to Q over 2 pi epsilon naught L into a log of B minus log of A. Log of B minus log of A. This is what we are getting, my dear friends. So this is how the value of potential is being generated, or it is being calculated. And when we find the capacitance, we have to put this value of potential to this formula, which is C is equal to Q by V. Now try to understand, there is a formula in our logarithm. Those students of mathematics, they know it. Okay, log B minus log A is equal to log of B over A. Log of B over A. That means I can write this is equal to Q over 2 pi epsilon naught L into log to the base E B over A. B over A. This value you put here, and finally we get the capacitance as, because it is Q by V. So Q and Q will cancel, my dear friends. So what I will be getting? 2 pi epsilon naught L over log of B by A to the base E. Log of B by A to the base E. Is it clear, my dear friends? Is it clear? Now, if you want to convert this, just remember one relation. just remember one relation, that log of log of A to the base E is equal to 2.303 log of A to the base 10, to the base 10, because in general we calculate the logarithm with the base as 10. So this is how you convert the log of log of A to the base E to log of A to the base 10 by simply multiplying by 2.303. So I hope you have got a clear idea how to calculate the potential in case of a spherical capacitor as well as a cylindrical capacitor. It is okay that in numerical purpose we directly go for the formulas, but derivation is also one of the important section. So till our next lecture, do take care of yourself, keep working hard, and enjoy your studies, and whenever you have doubt, you are most welcome. Thank you very much. God bless you all. All the best.